Life of Genevieve Nnaji. Genevieve Nnaji is one of Nollywood's most popular actresses, with an acting career spanning over two decades. She was born on the 3rd of May 1979 and is regarded as one of the pioneers of the modern Nollywood, and her acting prowess is recognized beyond the shores of Nigeria. During her still ongoing career in Nollywood, Genevieve Nnaji has received many awards and recognitions, even beyond Nollywood in some cases. Welcome to Drop It Media. In today's video, we'll be going over the life of Genevieve Nnaji. Before we begin, be sure to subscribe. We publish new videos every day and ring on the bell notification to stay updated each time we drop new videos. And you can also give your thoughts about the next celebrity we can talk about in the comment section below. With much talking I'm going to be doing today, I'd appreciate if you buy me a cup of coffee. I'll leave my account number in the description below. Genevieve Nnaji was born on the 3rd of May 1979 into a middle-class Nigerian family. She was the first child of a family that would later increase to 8 children. Nnaji was born in Mbaise, a popular region in Imo State in southeastern Nigeria. The region consists of several towns and cities. However, she didn't grow up in the region as the family moved to Lagos State. Genevieve's father, Theophilus Nnaji, worked as an engineer, while her mother, Bernadette Nnaji, was a nursery school teacher. The actress attended the revered Methodist Girls High School in Yaba, Lagos. The school was established in 1879 and is affiliated with the Methodist Church. It is also widely recognized as the second female secondary school and the third oldest secondary school in Nigeria. After completing an education, Genevieve Nnaji went on to the University of Lagos. There she got a degree in creative arts. Genevieve has always had a thing for acting and has begun starring in production at the age of 8. Her first appearance was in the popular now-rested NTA TV series Ripples, in which she appeared in 1988. Ripples was widely watched in Nigeria between 1988 to 1994. After the initial boost, she continued her passion while in school. Genevieve's first Nollywood film was in Most Wanted, which was released in 1998. She was at 19 at that time. The film also starred popular celebrities like Bob Manuel Udoku, Liz Benson, Ibinabo Febresima, and Regina Askia. By 1999, she was already playing major roles in Nollywood films and pulled in a stellar performance in the film Ijele. She also appeared in other successful films like Mark of the Beast and Last Party. As of the end of the year 2002, it was clear that Genevieve Nnaji was the force to reckon with in Nollywood. So dynamic was her character interpretation that it was difficult to box her. She delivered in her roles that cast her as a bad girl, with such convincing results that one could assume she was a bad girl in real life. Then, in other films, she is playing an innocent girl in love, and fans are left biting their thongs as they realize they have failed to correctly box her. Her roles in films like Runs and especially Sharon Stone caught not only the eyes of local viewers but those of the international community as well. Genevieve was popular and was among the first Nigerian actors to claim some prestigious awards. For example, according to Genevieve's Nnaji Wikipedia page, she became the first actor to be awarded at the 2001 City People's Award. She was crowned Best Actress at the award ceremony that previously only recognized politician and business conglomerates. In 2003, the National Film and Video Censors Board awarded her the Best Actress Award, and she became the first actor to receive such an honor. At the inaugural Africa Movie Academy Awards in 2005, Nnaji won the award for Best Actress in a Leading Role, becoming the first actress to win the award. Another testament to the fact that she was one of Nollywood's most notable pioneers. One of the notable memories of the early Nollywood Genevieve Nnaji films are those she acted alongside Ramsey Noah, and there are many of them to pick from, such films as Valentino, Power of Love, Love Boat, Butterfly, Honey, My Only Love, Passion, and Pain readily to come to mind. If there are others I omitted, you can let us know in the comment section below. Both actors were hailed the Romeo and Juliet of Nollywood. While Ramsey Noah has been married since 2002, many fans ignore the fact and genuinely believe that the on-screen chemistry they saw between the actor and actress must be real. However, both of them have debunked the rumors to discourage persistent fans. In 2013, Ramsey Noah opened up during an interview that while he admitted that Genevieve Nnaji is a good-looking woman, their relationship was only professional. Meanwhile, many will find articles on the internet that claims that Ramsey Noah and Genevieve Nnaji were in a relationship or dated. However, both of them have time and again refuted claims and at its best leave it at that. Also, in the early peak of Genevieve's popularity, she also acted in many films with Tony Umez, playing his wife or his girlfriend. Yet, it is the stories about Ramsey Noah that many seem to prefer flying with. If one is conversant with Nollywood film trends of the 2000s, one will inevitably notice that the number of films starring Genevieve Nnaji dropped after 2004. In fact, many of the films that were released after 2004 may have been recorded before then. This was because Genevieve Nnaji was part of the actors and actresses banned by Nollywood film marketers. The decision was referred to as G8's ban, and according to Paul Charles Novia, the ban was because the actors demanded huge sums but didn't deliver as expected. This ban led to the entrance of many new stars into Nollywood. Others implicated in the G8 ban were Ramsey Noah, Omotola Jared Nkinde, Richard Mofe Damijo, Emeka Ike, Nkemowo, Stella Damascus, and Jim Ike. While it seemed like most of the others waited out the Nollywood G8 ban, Genevieve Nnaji made an unexpected move into the music industry. More surprisingly was the fact that she did not even move into Nigerian music industry, but that of the country's West African rival, Ghana. Thus, in 2004, she signed a recording contract with EKB Records, a Ghanaian record label. Under this label, Genevieve dropped many singles that were surprisingly very good, and also released a debut album titled One Logo Logo Line. The album contains 8 songs, and in one of them, she featured VIP. VIP is a very popular Ghanaian music group. After this sojourn into the music world, Genevieve returned to the Nollywood scene around 2009. Returning to a more advanced Nollywood than the one she had left, it seems Genevieve Nnaji flourished more. It is hard to think that the already popular actress could set new standards in a game she was already agreeably leading, but that was what went down. Before her major return, fans had caught a glimpse of her starring in Mildred Okwu's 30 Days. 30 Days had been one of Nollywood's most revered films, and it famously got 8 nominations at the 2008 African Movie Academy Awards. Nollywood veteran Joel Silver clinched the award for Best Supporting Actress for her role in the film. In 2009, Genevieve starred in Silent Scandals, which also stars Majid Michael and Uche Jumbo. It was around that time that Oprah Winfrey featured the actress on her show tagged Meet the Most Famous People in the World. While highlighting her career high points, group photos and videos, Winfrey dubbed Genevieve Nnaji the Julia Roberts of Africa. Another successful film project starring Genevieve during this period was Ije, The Journey. Ije, The Journey also stars Omotola Jared Ekenden and Clem Ohaneze. It was a widely acclaimed Nollywood film directed by Chinese Ayane and won many awards. In 2011, Genevieve starred in the Nigerian fantasy adventure drama film titled The Mirror Boy, based on the screenplay by Obi Emelonye. The film also stars Osita Ihem. For her acting, Nnaji won the Best Actress Award at the Zulu African Film Academy Awards. Still on an impressive run, Genevieve Nnaji collaborated with Ramsey Noah, Iniedu, and Michael Okpara in 2012. Film Weekend Getaway. For this film, she won the Best Actress in a Leading Role Award at the Nollywood and African Films Critics Awards in 2013. Also, in the 2013 adaptation of Chimamanda Adichie's classic, Half a Yellow Sun, Genevieve Nnaji won the Best Actress in Supporting Role Award at the 2014 Nigerian Entertainment Awards. She starred in Dr. Bello, a 2013 Nigerian adventure drama film that was also directed by Tony Abolu. Other co-stars are Isaiah Washington, Vivica A. Fox, Jimmy Jean Lewis, Stephanie Okereke, Justus Esiri, Ebe Basi, and John Freda. The film got a nomination in the Best Actress Leading Role category at the 2013 Nigerian Entertainment Awards, but she didn't win the award. In 2015, Genevieve Nnaji tried her hands at something other than acting. She wrote and co-produced the film Road to Yesterday. Ishaya Bako directed this motion picture. The romantic drama stars actors like Oris Erure, Majid Michael, and comical actress Choma Chigol Omerua. While it got 2 nominations at the Nigerian Entertainment Awards in 2016, it didn't win in any of the categories. By 2018, Genevieve Nnaji had spent 2 decades on the screen and she was ready to dabble into film directing. For her directorial debut, Nnaji released Lionheart, which was highly acclaimed by critics and movie watchers. People were eager to see it and it totally lived up to its hype. Nnaji was able to pull off a remarkable feat. Well, if you are one of those many viewers here that haven't seen Lionheart, let us know in the comment section below. And those of you that have seen this movie, what do you make of it? Leave your ratings in the comment section below too. Lionheart was Nnaji's first film as a director, and she wrote and starred in it. Also, starring in the film are veteran Nollywood actors like Pete Edoche and Nke Mowo. She also handed Peter Okoye of the defunct P Square music duo and rapper Chibuzo Azubuike's, also known as Fino, their acting debuts. Lionheart premiered at the 2018 Toronto International Film Festival in Toronto, Ontario, Canada, where Netflix saw it and grabbed it, making Lionheart Netflix's first original Nollywood film. The film was also nominated for Gross People's Choice Award at the 2018 Toronto International Film Festival. Later in 2019, the film was submitted by the Nigerian Oscar Commission as the country's first ever submission for the Best International Feature Film for the 92nd Academy Awards. However, the film was disqualified for not meeting the eligibility criteria because most of the dialogue was shot in English language. This decision sparked controversy both in Nigeria and beyond. Lionheart won the Outstanding Foreign Film / World Cinema Motion Picture Award at the 19th Black Reel Awards in 2019. Netflix acquired Lionheart on the 7th of September 2018 for $3.8 million. This makes it the first Netflix original film produced in Nigeria. Well, did you know that Genevieve Nnaji is a member of the Order of the Federal Republic? Yes, that is correct. In 2011, then President Goodluck Jonathan conferred the honor of the MFR on the beautiful actress. She joins the very select people such as Stephanie Okereke, Ali Baba, the late Amaka Igwe, Omosola Jalel Ekende in the entertainment industry to have been so honored. While Genevieve Nnaji lives in a relatively quiet life and makes minimum use of her social media accounts, she has been named in several scandals even before the popularity of the internet. Many of the scandals usually involved men, although there was never any evidence to support them. Just wild allegations and speculations. Around 2005-2006, stories started to spread that she was involved with Atiku Abubakar, who was the vice president to President Olusegun Obasanjo. The stories were that Atiku Abubakar was one responsible for all her film gigs. Speculation also went around that he bought her houses and cars. In the end, there was no evidence to back up the rumors. Then later around 2009, stories also circulated that Genevieve Nnaji was involved with Tapo Oyabanchi, popularly called The Banj. As if to give this rumor some credence, she appeared in the video of his hit song, Fall in Love. However, details later emerged that the singer had paid her 2 million naira to be the video vixen. As in her culture, Genevieve Nnaji did not bother to give the speculation any form of response. Well, let's talk about Genevieve Nnaji's daughter. While many things regarding her private life are not publicly known, as she plays a card close to her chest, it is common knowledge that Genevieve has a daughter. She had given birth to the child allegedly at the age of 17, that was even before her first Nollywood movie. Her daughter, Theodora Chimebuka Nnaji, got married in 2016. According to reports, some reports say that Chimebuka Nnaji married Prince Osichigozie Ikediwa in her hometown, Mbaise, Imo State. It is also alleged that the couple relocated to Texas in the United States. Genevieve Nnaji seems to be very single, as she herself has never mentioned a husband or a partner. However, there have been rumors about her marrying an unnamed European man in Portugal in 2018. According to Legit, a source close to the Nollywood star had revealed details about the secret wedding. But there has not been any other mention or evidence of this supposed marriage.
We therefore conclude that it is likely just a speculation. If it was to be true, guys, we would have known by now. Charitable acts are seen as a way to give back to the society, especially when you have built a successful career thanks to it. Genevieve Nnaji understood this early in her career. That was why in 2008, Genevieve Nnaji launched a clothing line called St. Genevieve. The clothing business donates its proceeds to charities. Genevieve relaunched the business in 2014. Genevieve Nnaji is estimated to be about 9.2 million naira, dollar worth. Well, if there are any contrary estimated net worth of Genevieve Nnaji, please let us know in the comment section below. Conclusively, Genevieve Nnaji has proven time and again and beyond doubt that she's a very talented actress. She consistently displays outstanding performances in most of her projects. We can see the results in the numerous awards and worldwide recognitions she has garnered. Also, her experimentation into writing, producing and directing her own work has not gone unnoticed. In all of these, she remains a respected figure. She rarely ever makes societal comments online and stays away from scandals, except for the imaginary ones concocted by Adlers. Well, this woman is a foremost moving force and deserves all the praise she gets. With this, we think we can end today's video. If there are any notable facts regarding Genevieve Nnaji, kindly let us know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching today's video, and don't forget to stay well, stay safe, and peace.